Namaste students. So today we will continue with the chapter that is surface chemistry. So in your last class you have learned regarding the adsorption concept, which is nothing but just a surface phenomena where adsorption will takes place on the surface, which will be considered as adsorbent, and the molecule which will undergo for adsorption, that will be considered as adsorbate. So next you have learned regarding the difference between physisorption as well as chemisorption, where physisorption is nothing but which will form by weak van der Waals force of attraction, and it will be having less amount of energy when the releasing of energy will take place, because you know adsorption is isothermic process. So there, in the case of physisorption, less amount of energy will be released. In the case of chemisorption, if you look, there strong chemical bond will be there, so it will be strong in nature, and there it will be having, in the sense, it will release more amount of energy. Okay, heat of adsorption will be more in the case of chemisorption, and it is irreversible process also. In the case of physisorption, those are reversible process. So this is regarding differences between physisorption and chemisorption. Later you have learned regarding Fenwick adsorption theory in terms of gas as well as in terms of solution. So when you will take the example of gas in a container, when you will take adsorbent as well as gas molecule, when you are applying pressure, by that time you will be seeing, or you can observe, that the variation of the amount of gas adsorbed per mass of the adsorbent. Okay, so that will be considered as Fenwick adsorption isotherm. So the ratio, if you will go, it comes as x by m. Okay, so x by m versus pressure, if you will draw a graph, you will get x by m is equal to k into p to the power 1 by n. Okay, so now that is 1 by n, n is nothing but any kind of whole number you are supposed to take. So that depends on your adsorbent as well as adsorbate. So this is regarding your gas. Okay, so in terms of gas, when you take, this is the formula. So you can take logarithm concept so that you will get slope as well as intercept, and you can find the value of 1 by n as well as the k value, you will be able to find out. So next we have learned regarding Fenwick adsorption isotherm in terms of solution also. So what you are supposed to do, you are supposed to take a container, there you are supposed to take acetic acid in terms of solution, as a solution, and as an adsorbent you can take a charcoal. Same concept it will undergo, it will go with adsorption. So same kind of graph you are going to get, and there you are going to measure in terms of concentration. Okay, so you are not supposed to measure in terms of pressure. So the formula comes as x by m is equal to k into c to the power 1 by 1. So c is nothing but, it is nothing but molar concentration. So n goes with c. Okay, so that is nothing but Fenwick adsorption isotherm. So later you have learned regarding surface which effects, that is nothing but surface area, as it increases your adsorption increases, as well as if you will go with the temperature. Okay, so as the temperature will increases, adsorption process will decreases, and the pressure as it increases, your adsorption will increases. And later if you will go with the concentration term also, in terms of solution if you will go, so as concentration increases, adsorption will increases. So these are nothing but the simple factors which affects, as well as we have seen in some of the example also. So next concept that you will be learning under this chapter, that is nothing but catalysis. So what is mean by catalysis? Catalysis is nothing but, it is a substance which increases the rate of the reaction without undergoing any chemical change. Okay, it will not undergo for any chemical change, but it helps to faster the reaction. Okay, just to faster the reaction, you need some substance. So that substance will be called as catalyst in your lower classes. Okay, you might have studied. Regarding your vegetable oil, the conversion of vegetable oil to vegetable ghee, which will be called as vanaspati. So that process will be done in the presence of hydrogen, hydrogenation we are going to call. Okay, so that process you might have learned in the presence of a catalyst. Okay, as you remember, nickel as a catalyst. So that is one example. So example, if I vegetable oil which undergoes hydrogenation in the presence of nickel as a catalyst, so you will get vegetable ghee. So simple example which you have learned. Okay, so the catalyst is nothing but, it is a substance. Okay, this will never undergo for reaction, but it will just help to faster the reaction. A simple example if I tell, we teachers also acts like a catalyst in your students' life. How it will be? Students, you people nowadays, you will get all the whatever the required concept, okay, everything you will get at your home only. But then also you will come to school or college to learn. Why? Because here teachers are there. So we will help you to learn in first level. Okay. So even we are acting like a kettle. Just one example I told. So in here in chemistry, catalyst is nothing but it is a substance which will help to faster the reaction, but it will never undergo a reaction. Okay, so that will be considered as catalyst. Some more example if I go. You can take potassium chloride. Okay. So potassium chloride in the presence of manganese dioxide, you are going to get KCl as well as oxygen. Okay. So oxygen molecules will be formed. So this reaction will be done in the presence of your manganese dioxide. So this manganese dioxide is acting as a catalyst just to it will help to faster the reaction. Okay. So just to faster the reaction. Some other example if I go, nitrogen as well as hydrogen, which is ammonia, which will be considered as CO2, very important for study. We will be learning this concept later. Okay. So simple example I take. Nitrogen, hydrogen, it will react and you are going to get ammonia. So this reaction takes longer time. So what we are doing, we are using a catalyst. So when we use this catalyst, it helps to faster the reaction. The rate of reaction will become faster in rate. So this will be the catalyst. So this is one more example. So we will go through some of the examples when you are learning regarding the types of the catalyst. So now, here under catalyst, two concepts you will be learning. Okay, what are those concepts? One is known as promoter and another is known as poison. Now what does it mean? Okay, promoter is nothing but here it helps to increase the activity of catalyst. Okay, so this will help to increase the activity of catalyst. So that will be considered as promoter. Okay, this promoter will promote this catalyst. It helps to increase the activity of this catalyst. We are going to consider as promoter. Poisons are nothing but it helps to, or this will go with decreasing the rate of the reaction of a catalyst. Okay, so this poison decreases the activity of a catalyst. So that will be considered as poisons. Okay. Now we go with examples of promoters. Simple example. This example I will take now. Nitrogen. Okay. Reacts with hydrogen to give ammonia. Okay. Balance reaction. Now as I said, this reaction will be done in the presence of a catalyst. That is nothing but iron. Okay. So now to increase the activity of this, still more faster. Okay, you want that reaction still more faster. Okay, so what you will do? You will be adding one of the substance, so which will be considered as a promoter. So if you add that substance, for example, for this reaction, molybdenum. Okay, it is a promoter. So when you add molybdenum, this will help to faster the reaction of a catalyst. Okay, so for example, if the reaction is run, okay, generally some reactant you will add so that you will get a product, so that reaction consider that will be done in 2 hours. But when you will add a catalyst, okay, the reaction will be done in faster. So that 2 hours reaction will be done within a half an hour. Example I am saying. Okay, so faster. If you will add promoter, still more faster. Within 10 minutes the reaction will finish. Okay. So this is the use of the your promoter. So this promoter helps to faster the reaction of your catalyst. Next, if you go with the poison. So example, contact process where the production of sulfuric acid will be done. So regarding this reaction, you will be learning later. Okay. So remember, when this production of sulfuric acid will be done. Okay. So by that time you will be having, catalyst will be there. Okay, catalysts are present, but not this catalyst, some of the catalysts are present over there. Okay. So but what will happen in the presence of catalyst, the reaction sometime it will become in slower rate. Why it is so? Because it will have some of the poisons. Okay. So what does clean poisons are nothing but which decreases the activity of cattle. So in this section we consider your dust, arsenic as well as mercury ions if it is present in the reaction. So then these three will be considered as poisons which will decreases the activity of cattle. So when it decreases, I mean that activity of your cattle will become slow. So that is the work of your poison as well as promoter. I guess you understood regarding these two concepts. So next we will go with the concepts, the types of catalysts we just learned. Okay, so types of the catalysts. So next we will be studying regarding the types of catalysts. So generally two types of catalysts are present. One is known as homogeneous catalyst and another is known as heterogeneous catalyst. Now what does it mean? Homo means what? Same, right? Hetero means what? Different. So here, homogeneous catalysts are nothing but which will have same phase. Okay? So homo is nothing but same. So same phase of reactants and catalysts. Reactants as well as catalyst phases are same, then you are going to consider as homogeneous catalyst. What is mean by phase? Phase are nothing but different states. Okay, solid, liquid, gas, aqueous, all those things. Okay, so now based on those phases, you are going to divide. You have divided as homogeneous as well as heterogeneous. So if reactant and catalyst both are there in the same phase, then you are going to call it as homogeneous catalysis. Heterogeneous catalysis are nothing, right? If it is having hetero in the sense for different, right? So here, different phase of reactant and catalyst, then you are going to consider as heterogeneous. So hetero, as I said, hetero means different. So the here if you consider reactant as well as catalyst phase should be different. Okay? So some of the examples means the first example, oxidation of sulfur dioxide. Both the cases are in the same example by using of different catalysts. Okay. So now oxidation of sulfur dioxide to sulfur trioxide. Okay. How it will be done? This will be done in the presence of nitric oxide. Okay, so nitric oxide is a catalyst. Now, what is the phase of sulfur dioxide? This is a gasoline state. Oxygen, obviously, it is gasoline state. This nitric oxide is gasoline state. Okay, see, the phase of your reactant, these are reactant, both are gasoline state, as well as your catalyst. Catalyst also gaseous in state. So, the reactants as well as catalyst phases are same when you are going to consider as homogeneous catalysis. If you go with the heterogeneous catalysis, example, same example I will consider, oxidation of your sulfur dioxide to sulfur trioxide, and it will be done in the presence of the catalyst, what will I use? It is cutting. Okay. So what is the phase of your sulfur dioxide? That is nothing but gaseous state, right? So what is the phase of your platinum? That is solid. So your phase of your reactant as well as catalyst both has been changed. Okay. So different phases it is having. Then you are going to consider as heterogeneous catalyst. I guess you understood the difference between homogeneous as well as heterogeneous catalyst. Now we will go with some of the examples. I will skip under this concept. Now one I already have given. Just three examples I will give. Okay. So under this concept also three examples I will give. So whichever you feel easy, that way you have to learn. Okay. So now this is the easy action. Next example, if I go, so balance the reaction. Next one, carbon monoxide. Okay, so carbon monoxide immediately undergoes oxidation in the presence of same catalyst you use. It is easy to remember. Okay, so carbon monoxide when it undergoes oxidation, you will get carbon dioxide. Okay, CO2. Again, you have to balance the reaction. Okay, two oxygen as well as two oxygen here, four. Same thing, oxidation of your carbon monoxide, you get
carbon dioxide by using of nitric oxide. So carbon monoxide phases, yes, oxygen phases, gas resignation, as well as nitric oxide is gas resignation. So phases are same. Okay, so then you can go with homogeneous catalysis. Further example I will give for homogeneous catalysis, that is nothing but ozone. Okay, when it undergoes decomposition in the presence of CLK, so that you will get oxygen. Okay, so now this is a catalyst. So now phase of catalyst is oxygen gas, sorry, ozone gas, then oxygen gas, fluorine gas. So all are in gaseous state. Okay, so that is nothing but homogeneous catalyst. All are there in same phase. It need not to be, it should be there in gaseous phase itself. It can be there in any case, but in case your reactant as well as your catalyst is there in the same phase. Okay, so now this is one example. One more example if I give, methyl acetate. Okay, methyl acetate, when it undergo hydrolysis, you will get acetic acid as well as methanol will be formed as a product. But if you are using a catalyst, the reaction will be done in faster rate. So now your methyl acetate is, what is the phase of methyl acetate? Liquid. Water, liquid. HCl, liquid. So all the phases are same. Just to give one example, different example, other than gas also, different phases are present. For that, it's an argument, this is good. So whichever you feel easy, at least minimum two examples you are supposed to learn under this one. Again, here also I'll give one. Some more example, okay? So sulfur dioxide already I have given by using of platinum only one reaction rate, okay? Ammonia on oxidation, okay? You will get nitric oxide as well as water molecule will be formed, okay? As a product. So here again platinum only will be used as a catalyst. You know the state of platinum, that is solid and state. This is gas. Differences. The reactants are there in gaseous phase as well as your catalyst is there in solid phase. Different phases. One more example if you will consider, which I have already learned from. Huh? Whether the reaction is balanced is well. Reaction is balanced. Now you can go with another example. Nitrogen as well as hydrogen, you will get ammonia. So this catalyst that you are using, that is iron as a catalyst. Okay. So nitrogen is there with the gaseous form. Hydrogen is there with the gaseous form. Iron is there with the solid form. Okay. So this is one more example where you can say that the phases are different of your reactant as well as catalyst. One more example you have already given, that is nothing but vegetable oil. Okay, so now vegetable oil, when it undergoes hydrogenation, then you will get vegetable ghee. Okay, vegetable ghee will be formed. This will be done in the presence of nickel as a catalyst. So here if you go, vegetable oil, oil is nothing but liquid form, hydrogen gas, nickel as a catalyst, it is there in the solid form. Different phases, reactants are, the one is there with the liquid form, one is there with the gaseous form. So different phases are there when you compare with your catalyst. So homogeneous catalysts are nothing but your reactant as well as catalyst should be there in the same phase, same state. Okay? Heterogeneous catalysts are nothing but it should be there in different phase. So generally if you consider the heterogeneous catalyst, most of the time, this catalyst are there in the solid form. Okay, it need not to be compulsory. So most of the time, if you consider these examples, if you consider, all are there with solid form. So generally, this catalyst, it goes with the solid when you go with heterogeneous catalysis. As well as reactants, it can be gaseous state or it can be of liquid state also. Okay. So generally, we are going to call this as surface catalysis, because catalyst we are using as solid, so your adsorption will take place on the surface. The reaction will take place on the solid surface. Okay, so we are going to call it as surface catalysis. So one more name for heterogeneous catalysis that we will give as surface catalysis. I guess you have understood regarding these two concepts. Okay, homogeneous as well as heterogeneous. Very important concept it is. And next, you will be learning regarding the theory or mechanism of this catalysis. So next we will go for adsorption theory of heterogeneous catalysis, which I told, last concept. Okay. So as I have told, the types of catalysts, that is homogeneous and heterogeneous. Heterogeneous catalysis, where most of the time solid catalysts will be there, so we are going to consider as surface catalysis, and the reactants either it will be there with a gaseous form or solution form. Okay. So those kind of catalysis, how it will work or how the mechanism will go. So that we are going to learn under this concept, that is nothing but adsorption theory of heterogeneous catalysis. Total we are having 5 sets. This mechanism is important. Okay. So total 5 sets are there. So remember this concept: diffusion, adsorption, reaction, desorption. Again, the last process is diffusion. So BARDD. Okay. Remember like that. So that is nothing but the 5 sets which we will be having, or which we are going to consider as a theory of only the heterogeneous catalysis. Okay. So how it goes? The first, what will happen? First, it goes with diffusion of the reactant to the catalytic surface. For example, consider this is the catalytic surface. Okay. So catalytic surface is nothing but it will be having number of pores. So consider this is a catalyst. So now reactants will come contact with the catalyst. For example, consider now two reactants are A and B. Okay, two reactants, it will come in contact with your catalyst, so that will be considered as diffusion. So diffusion of these two reactants to the catalyst surface, you are leaving those two reactants on the catalyst surface. Okay, so that is nothing but diffusion. Next, what will happen? Adsorption of the reactant molecule on the surface. So as you will leave these reactants on the surface, these will absorbed by this catalyst. Okay, so reactants will be absorbed by the catalyst. So this is a catalyst, is that means in a sense here reactant will be absorbed. You know what is mean by absorption? So surface phenomena. So here only to the surface. Now, for example, this is a catalyst. Now two reactants are left over here. So what is catalyst? It will do. It will absorb these two reactants. Okay. So third step. See, remember adsorption when it goes. You have learned adsorption is nothing but there. It is an exothermic process. So some amount of heat or energy will be released. So what will happen when it releases some amount of energy? By that time, these reactants, whatever has been absorbed by the catalyst, so these reactants will absorb that energy. Okay. So it will use it, utilize that energy, and these two reactants will become active state. So next step, what will happen? Reaction will take place between those reactant. Okay, absorb the reactant. Between these reaction will take place. As you know, catalyst, it will never undergo for reaction. It has to just pass through the reaction. How it will pass through the reaction? By this procedure. First, diffusion will take place. Later, adsorption of those molecule will take place. So it is already adsorbed. Now, reaction between these two reactants will take place. So that you will get the products. When these two will react, obviously chemical bond formation will take place between them and formation of product will take place. Okay, so these two reactants will react together and you will get the product. Okay, so that is nothing but reaction. So as the reaction will increase, in the sense concentration of the reactants will go on increasing, so that the rate of the reaction, in the sense the time, whatever it will consume, it will become faster rate. Okay, so the rate of reaction will become faster over here. Next step, fourth step is nothing but, that is nothing but desorption of the product molecule from the surface. What is meant by desorption? Desorption is nothing but, we have learned, adsorption is just absorbing the molecule on the surface. Desorption is nothing but removal of these adsorbed molecules from the surface. Okay, so that is nothing but, that we are going to call it as desorption. So here desorption will take place, in the sense whatever the reactant has been absorbed, product has been formed, those product will be removed from the surface. Okay, so these product will be removed. Okay, now this is in product form. Okay, you cannot write it as A plus B. A plus B in the sense those are reactants. Now those reactants has combined, in the sense those have been reacted together and you got a product. Okay, so now this is there as product form. So these product has been removed. Okay, from here the product has been removed. So that is nothing but desorption. The last step is diffusion of the product molecule away from the surface. It cannot stay with your catalyst. Okay, because this catalyst surface it is required for next reaction. Okay, so what it will do, once the product has been formed, once the product has been removed from the surface, after that, that product will be, those product will move away from the surface. Okay, it will move away from the catalyst surface. So that will be considered as diffusion of the product molecule. So let's say the first one, the diffusion of the reactant molecule on the surface. You are releasing these reactant to the catalyst. So when you are releasing, the second step, it will absorb the reactant molecule. Third step, what will happen after absorbing, between those reactant, reaction will take place so that one product will be formed. So your new product formation will take place. So as a fourth step, this product will be removed. Okay, so which will be considered as desorption. So these products will be removed. As a last step, these products will move away from the surface of the catalyst so that it will be allowed for the next reaction. Okay, so these catalysts will be allowed for the next reaction. So this is a simple mechanism of your heterogeneous catalysis. As I said, in heterogeneous catalysis, the concentration will increase, the rate of the reaction will increase. If surface area is more, the rate of reaction will become more. So as I know, regarding the reaction, when the reaction will take place, absorption, some amount of energy it will release. So what it will do, it will absorb those energy and those reactant will become active in state. So that the reaction will become faster in state. So this is the procedure that it will take place in heterogeneous catalysis. So next we'll be learning regarding the important features of these catalysis. Okay.